वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द चैप्टर द पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ अ लेडी बाय खुशवंत सिंह। लेट अस बिगिन विद द सेकेंड पैराग्राफ ऑफ द चैप्टर द पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ अ लेडी बाय खुशवंत सिंह। सो इन दिस पैराग्राफ वी विल कम टू नो अबाउट द फिजिकल डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द ऑथर्स ग्रैंड मदर एंड हियर आई हैव पॉइंटेड आउट सम मेन पॉइंट्स विच बेसिकली डिस्क्राइब्स द ऑथर्स ग्रैंड मदर। नाउ लेट अस सी दिस इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स। शी वॉज शॉर्ट, फैट एंड स्लाइटली बेंट। She had wrinkles on her face. She was of same age for 20 years and she was like the expanse of pure white serenity. So these are some important points which basically describes the author's grandmother. Now let us read these lines from the second paragraph, and as I read I want all of you to concentrate on these lines. She had always been short and fat and slightly bent. Her face was a crisscross of wrinkles running from everywhere to everywhere. No, we were certain she had always been, as we had known her, old as terribly old, that she could not have grown older, and had stayed at the same age for 20 years. She could never have been pretty, but she was always beautiful. She hoggled about the house in spotless white, with one hand resting on her waist to balance her stoop, and the other telling the beads of her rosary. Her silver locks were scattered untidily over her pale, puckered face, and her lips constantly moved in an inaudible prayer. Yes, she was beautiful. She was like the winter landscape in the mountains, an expanse of pure, white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. Now see this first line, she had always been short and fat and slightly bent. So the narrator clearly describes the physical description of our grandmother, that she was short, she was fat, and she was slightly bent as she was old. And as she is a very old lady, here he tells us that her face is filled up with wrinkles, and these wrinkles ran from here and there in her face. Now the author tells us that since from his childhood till then, when he saw his grandmother, he felt that his grandmother was so old that she can't be more old anymore. And since from 20 years she remained same. That is why he wrote here that she was old as terribly old, that she could not have grown older, and she had stayed at the same age for 20 years. That is why he tells us that she seemed so old and she had been the same for the past 20 years. Now see, the author tells us that according to him that she was beautiful, but it was very hard for him to believe that she can be pretty also. Now she used to move about here and there in the house, and she walked around the house in a very awkward way, and she wore a white sari which was spotless white, and she carried in one hand the beads of the rosary, and it hanged from her hand, and she was continuously praying with that rosary, and the other hand it rested on her back for support. And she had silver colored hair, and as she had silver locks, those silver locks, you know, scattered untidily over her pale puckered face. So she had silver colored hair which was not neatly combed actually, and was disorganized. Now she was constantly chanting prayers. She was constantly chanting prayers, and it was inaudible, it was not clear, but one can easily recognize that she was chanting some prayers. And she was beautiful. Now the author tells us that yes, definitely she is beautiful. And here he compares his own grandmother with the winter landscape in the mountain. So he compares his grandmother with those snow-capped mountains which is spotless white. So that is why here he referred this line, that an expanse of pure white serenity breeding peace and contentment. Means it felt that she was in a very serene position, she was very calm. Okay, and she was a live example of pure white and peace entity, emanating all these calmness, peace and tranquility. So these are some important words from the second paragraph. Now see, crisscross, it means the cross pattern of intersecting lines. Hobbled, walked in an awkward way. Spotless white, she wore clean white colored dress. Means it tells us about her white sari. Stoop, bends one's body forward. So since she was an old lady, she used to bend and walk. Puckered, a face contract into wrinkles. So puckered means Those wrinkles in her face were all disorganized and her face was filled with wrinkles. Serenity, the state of being peaceful and calm. So as the author compared her with that expanse of pure white serenity, so she looked completely peaceful and calm. Contentment, a state of happiness and satisfaction. An expanse of pure white serenity here, this line in with reference to the paragraph 1 where the author compares his grandmother here, it means that it refers to the calm, relaxed and peaceful character of the author's grandmother. These are some important questions I have listed out from the second paragraph and I will discuss with you all, and each of this question carries 2 marks. Now see this first question. Give a pen picture of the narrator's grandmother as witnessed by the author when he was a child. So in this question you have to write about the physical description of the narrator's grandmother, how she looked like, what she did, what she was wearing, everything, the way the narrator described us about her. Now in the second question, the grandmother was an expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. As I have already explained you all, you have to write about the calm and peaceful state of the grandmother. Why the grandmother has been compared with an expanse pure white serenity. Why the author compared the grandmother with the snow-capped mountains. And why she is considered here as a pure white serenity. So she looked peaceful, she looked happy, she looked contentment. So you have to write about this, that she was a live example of pure white peace emanating entity. Now the third question, that is, what made the author to opine also terribly old that she could not have grown older. So in this question here you have to write that the narrator's grandmother was so old that she could not be older anymore. So she looked for 20 years the same. Okay, so that is why you have to write here that she looked very old, she couldn't grow more older, and she looked for the same for 20 years.